The following program has been approved by Baby Joyce.
I like it!
That's right, boys and girls. When you hear that clippy-clop sound, you know it's time for Cactus Jack's Roundup! So put on your hat, shine up your spurs, and get ready for fun and adventure in the wild and woolly west. And if you don't watch out, partner, you just might learn something.
Clippy-clop, that happy sound. Clippy-clop, hooves touch the ground. Clippy-clop, we're happy all the day. Clippy-clop, we'll have some fun. Clippy-clop, till it's time to run. Then we'll all be back another day.
With a hey and a howdy and a how do you do? With a rope and a saddle and a big horseshoe. A tumbleweed and an old canteen. Prettiest town you've ever seen. Feet up boots and a big root beer. A bucking bronc and a longhorn steer. With a shiny spur and a wagon wheel. Happy is what we make you feel.
Clippy-clop, that happy sound. Clippy-clop, hooves touch the ground. Clippy-clop, we're happy all the day. Clippy-clop, we'll have some fun. Clippy-clop, till it's time to run. Then we'll all be back another day.
Hey, Mayor.
Well, hey, Cactus Jack. How are you?
I'm doing good. How about you?
Really well. Well, what's going on today?
Well, I'll tell you what. I think I'll head over to Pagosa Springs. I got something I want to show the kids. It's pretty special. I put Tumbleweed in charge. So, if you need anything, you let him know.
All right, Tumbleweed. Okay. I'll check with him.
There you go. Adios, my friend.
Have a good trip.
I will.
Adios.
Yes, sir. It's been a while, ain't it?
Yeah.
It's been a while. That's right. Well, I'll tell you what. Let me close this door for you.
Yep.
Now, but before we get started here, boys and girls, this is Fred Harmon, and this is the son of the original Fred Harmon, who created the Red Rider and Little Beaver. Now, they is real famous in that time, and this old museum is dedicated to that, so he's going to take us on through. How about that?
Yeah. Hey, Mary!
Hey, Tumbleweed.
Guess what?
What?
Cactus Jack went to Pagosa Springs and he put me in charge while he's away.
Pagosa Springs and put you in charge? Well, that makes me feel a lot better. Well, hello.
Thank you. Who was that?
Why, that was Apple Annie. And I think you were the apple of her eye.
You think so?
Here's some of the art that's hanging on the walls. It shows some of the old Indians that used to camp out on our ranch years ago, these two.
Do you really think she likes me?
Oh, Tumbleweed, I think she really does.
I don't know.
What am I supposed to do?
Well, impress her. Take her out on a picnic. She'd like that.
Maybe she likes big, strong guys like John Wayne.
There's right and there's wrong. You gotta do one or the other. You do the one and you're living. You do the other and you may be walking around, but you're dead as a beaver hat.
That's a great idea, may or may not. Thank you very much.
But wait, Tumbleweed, that's not what I meant.
Now, your daddy actually worked right here?
Yeah, right here. This is the cartoons that he used to do daily. This happens to be a Sunday page.
That's pretty impressive, I tell you, boys and girls.
Yeah. And here's something very interesting. I don't know, you can guess how many horses are on that thing, but it's a tremendous amount. 427 different horses.
Wow! 427?
Yep, 427.
You don't mind if I stand here and count them all, do you?
No.
Okay, we'll be back later, boys and girls. I'm gonna count all these horses.
apple, Annie. What are you doing?
Eating an apple. An apple a day keeps the doctor away.
Well, aren't you just a little Miss Know-It-All? Would you like to go on a picnic with me?
That'll be the day.
Yep, he's 427 horses right here, boys and girls. He ain't just pulling your leg. I counted every one of them.
Bear may not! Hey, I asked Apple Annie on a picnic and she didn't want to go.
She didn't want to go?
No.
Why?
Well, I don't know. I went there like John Wayne, you know, and it just, she didn't seem to like me. I don't think you're right.
Well, maybe you need to be more sincere. That she needs to really see who you are.
Yeah. I'll be like the strong silent type, like Clint Eastwood. Great idea, Mayor Maynard. Thank you very much.
Wait a minute. That's not exactly what I meant.
Howdy, ma'am. What's cooking?
Apple pie.
Well, I don't really like pie, so go ahead and bake my cake.
You're strange.
May or may not.
Yeah, Tumbleweed.
Apple Annie doesn't like me. You were wrong.
She doesn't like you.
No.
Well, maybe it's your approach.
What do you mean?
Well, maybe you're trying to be somebody you're not. Go back and talk to her and just be yourself. That's what she's interested in.
Be myself?
Be yourself. Your real self.
Okay. Hi, Annie.
Hello, Tumbleweed.
Annie, why don't you want to go on a picnic with me?
Oh, Tumbleweed, I do want to go on a picnic with you. But you are acting like all those other people, and I don't know them. I want you to be yourself.
Really?
Yeah. I want to go on a picnic with you, Tumbleweed.
Okay!
You know, I've really had a good time being in charge, but I heard Cactus Jack just got back, so I'm not in charge anymore.
You've done a good job.
Hey, boys, how's it going?
Cactus Jack!
Hey, Tumbleweed! Hey, good to see you, Mayor.
Welcome back.
Hey, look what I got!
Ooh, what'd you get me?
Tumbleweed, ain't you ever heard it's better to give than to get?
What are you gonna give me?
A little beaver comic book.
Ooh! I can't wait to show this to Apple Annie! I'm gonna go show her right now!
Well, he's out of here.
He's gone.
Look what I got for you, Mayor. A Red Rider calendar.
Give me that!
Beef?
Apples are good for you. They're full of vitamins and minerals that make you grow strong and healthy.
Well, Mayor, it's about time to say adios. But before we do, there's one more thing we gotta do. Hit it, Tumbleweed!
Goodbye.
See you next time, boys and girls. Adios.
Go for it.
It'd
be a stinger. What do you think?
And that's a bee's stinger. Little butt.
Oh, wow. More traps.
No.